gentlemen, Erika Ropati-Frost, Eagles of National Wear.
Come on!
Come on, you got on. This.
Finish, Erika!
Come on, big pull.
Erika, can you believe it?
I knew it was going to happen one day, but I'm so glad it's today. I don't know what to say. Very happy with that, and like, I knew I had the strength. I don't know about, you know, with dropping body weight, because, you know, sometimes you lose the strength. But it was a tough one, but it was well worth the hard fight, that one.
It's been a goal of yours for so long now, and you've worked so hard to get there, and then it's here, it's happened.
Finally, like, you know, I've done these sort of weights separately since the beginning of the year. I finally put it together around mid-year, so to finally put it on platform, it's absolutely fantastic. So, you know, I can't even believe I did this sort of total a couple weekends ago, but to do it as a 53, it's even better. So it's really going to put me in a good spot for Worlds and the Rio trials and everything. So very excited.
And just, I know you've got the medal ceremony coming up, but just take me through that lift. What was going through your mind, and did you feel like you had it in control from the start?
No, not at all. Like, my first two lifts, especially my first one, my jerk was forward. My second one felt a little bit unsteady as well, so I was really not feeling confident for the 106, but, you know, I knew this is what I've been training hard for, and after the clean, like, that felt like it took about 10 minutes to stand up out of it. So I couldn't even see the crowd. I was just so out of it after the clean. And I kept thinking about this, like, usually when I'm in the jerk and I'm feeling a bit lethargic and a bit dizzy even, it really gets to me. So this time I just remembered, like, no matter what, you really need to drive hard with your legs, and that will take you to where you need to be. So I gave it all, and it got up there, and the crowd, the energy was fantastic. So definitely big thanks to the crowd, because without them, you know, I really needed them for that one. So that was, yeah, unreal. Very happy.
And there are tears today, and I think that you can be excused for that, though, because it's been an emotional journey, and you just hugged your husband, Tony, and it's been such a tough ride at times, hasn't it? So this must make it all worthwhile.
Definitely. Like, you know, I think because I did feel a bit of pressure with getting this. You know, a lot of people had expectations and hopes, so really wanted to meet them and not fall behind again, which I felt that I've done, you know, for the past few competitions. So really glad to get it out there finally, and now it's just, you know, forwards and upwards, so got to keep it going.
And you've made history. You're the first person in Australia ever to do this.
I mean, that's probably why I'm so emotional, like, to really set something, and, you know, I guess footprints in unwalked sand type thing, like, that's my image, you know. I want to keep pushing forward, and to be able to be the first woman in Australia, that's something I'll have forever. So I'm so happy and so proud of this moment.
We're so proud of you. Well done.
Thank you so much. Thank you.